Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial dedicated to Autodesk Revit, an excellent software to build complete 2D and 3D models for windows. In just 10 minutes, we are going to see everything you need to know to start using it. When opening Revit, its homepage shows up with several options to start from a new project, or any existing one you have. You also have two main kinds of projects, the models and the families. The models are complete project designs made by several compositions put together. The families represent the single compositions you use in a single or multiple Revit projects. Both models and families are divided into four main groups, such as specific ones for detailed constructions, optimized ones for architectural buildings, materials and skeletons for structural projects, and tubes and conductors for systemic projects. To understand how to use Revit, let's start from a new model project using architectural tools and metric scale. This opens the main interface with the main preview on the center, several panels on the left, and ribbon bar on top, collecting all the main drawing and editing tools. In this video, we are going to see the main ones under the Architecture tab. Some of these buttons collect multiple tools under the arrow button that you can check in detail by hovering over these. We are going to see the main tools inside the Build section. You can also go to View, User Interface to hide or show any panel, and to File, Options, User Interface to use a darker theme. The main preview shows the projects in progress from top to bottom in a view called Level 1, which also represents the ground plane. You can see this from the tab on top. Let's start drawing a floor with the Architectural Floor tool. This enables the Edit mode, showing the green Modify tab with several drawing tools you can use to drop the floor. With Line, Arc, or Spline, you can draw segments and curves by clicking on the preview, using the Escape key to finish. Whereas use Rectangle, Polygon, and Circle to draw regular shapes, using the Escape key to undo. Make sure to use Control and Z to undo any drawing if you need. The pink drawings you see on the preview are indeed sketches in progress. On Modify mode, you can either cancel the current sketch or approve it with Finish Edit mode. In this case, the sketches are finally rendered into the designed floor. You can always double-click on it to enter again into Edit mode and modify the basic sketch. Pay attention that you build a single object per Edit mode, even if the sketches seem independent. To drop independent objects, make sure to enable any drawing tool when you are not editing any sketch. To check your project in progress, use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out around your cursor, and hold down the Shift key with your right click to pan. Revit includes very useful drawing aids while dealing with sketches. You get snappings to object key points such as endpoints, midpoints, intersections, and much more belonging to the current pink sketch or other objects. You can turn off or manage snappings by going to Manage, Snaps. You also get dashed guidelines to draw through extended directions and paths, and instant measurements on length and angles using the default project units. To adjust these, go to Manage, Project Units. After the floor, you can enable the Wall tool to drop walls on the floor contours with same drawing tools we have seen before. In particular, Revit will join walls together if they intersect. To preview the walls, you can switch to a complete 3D view by going to View, 3D View. At this point, you can use the 3D View cube on the right to change point of view. Click on any face or vertex. Click and drag to orbit around, or use the arrows to rotate by 90 degrees. You can also show the full navigation wheel to pan, orbit, or zoom in and out. The 3D view shows the height of the walls that you can check by selecting any and using the new Measure Between Two References tool. You can also drop further walls in this view, adjusting the height level above. These walls always get their base laying on the ground plane. You can customize any wall by double-clicking on it to enter the edit mode and reshaping its basic sketch, as seen for the floors. Levels and elevators are very important views that ease your drawing on 3D projects. From the Project Browser panel, you can double-click on any of these views to preview these on a dedicated tab. You can also right-click to rename or delete any. Levels or floor plans are indeed 2D views showing the project from the top down to a proper height, such as the ground, or 0 meters for level 1, and 4 meters for level 2 by default. Whereas elevations are 2D views showing the project in front from the east, north, south, or west, very useful to check height and depth. You can also create custom views. To make a new level, open any elevation view and, under the Architecture tab, go to Levels. Fix two points to drop a new height level as a dashed line, using the Escape key to apply. Then double-click on it to define its height precisely. To make a new elevation, open any level view and go to View, Elevation. This is shown as a circle with an arrow defining its direction. Use the Escape key to apply, and use the Modify tool to select it and rotate it if needed. Once walls are placed, you can add doors and windows on it while using a 3D view. Enable the Door tool to drop doors, with their base on a specific level height. Whereas use Window to add windows freely. Doors and windows are ready to use Revit family templates that you can select from the Properties panel on the left. You can also find furniture, trees, and much more from component above. At this point, you can add the top roof. Enable the Roof tool and select the highest level to use as base. Of course, not the grounded level 1. If this dialog does not show up, you can manually manage the reference to take as base, also called Work Plane. From the Architecture tab, go to Work Plane and click on Show to see the actual reference. And use Set to change it to another level. This way, the roof will take the chosen level as base. Once you click on the Roof tool, you can use the Drawing tools to define the roof contours and apply the sketch to obtain the rendered roof. Also select whether to attach or link the roof with the wall contours and make these dependent. The roof gets slopes for each side that has the defined slope option turned on, showing triangle markers. For example, if this option is disabled for all the sides, you obtain a completely flat roof. In this case, you can go to Modify, Shape Editing to make a custom roof by adding points and lines and applying with the Escape key. Then click on Modify Sub Elements to drag these and build the correct slopes. Your first house is done! You can always edit any element with the Modify tool. Click on any object to select it and drag its nodes to move, rotate, or adjust height. Whereas use Ctrl and X, C, and V to cut, copy, or paste a selected object, and the Delete key to remove it. You also have several editing tools on top. Select any object and enable any tool from the Modify tab to move, rotate, or mirror. Now let's see how to render your preview. At the bottom, use Visual Style to change the way to represent objects by using realistic colors or simple sketch wireframes. If you prefer a complete rendering, go to View, Render. To save your project, use the Save button on top or Control and S. Revit models are saved as .rvt files with everything you need to reopen it later. This is all. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Do not forget to visit and subscribe to our channel to discover more free tutorials.